Good evening, everyone. It's been a long time since I've made a video, so I thought I'd start by translating a popular Russian video on the subject of mud flood. In Russian, they refer to the mud flood phenomenon as cultural layer, or rather, kulturny sloy. The following video is by a popular channel called Kromola, a word which loosely translates to sedition or insurrection. Special thanks to Kromola. I recommend checking out his videos. And if you like this video, please show your appreciation by going to his channel and giving his videos a thumbs up. I'm not a native speaker of Russian, although I have been trying to study Russian in my free time. I have made translations to the best of my ability, and please forgive any mistakes I have made. Спасибо большое, Кромола. Мне нравится твой видео. People are not aware of the absurdity happening around them. From a young age, people see the architecture of ancient buildings and monuments. They admire their style, beauty, and shape, but they fail to see what is at the root of our history. On such buildings, structures appear immersed in the ground. The earth covers the first, and sometimes even second, story. In a previous video, Kromola covered 10 facts about the flood that will change world history. That video was bombarded by official history type criticism. Some said the ground was only raised by the weight of the buildings. Official historians scoff. Still, why would you build a building and then bury the windows and doors 5 meters below ground? So, apparently in the design of the building, below ground windows were installed for the sake of future excavation. Windows ready for unearthing. I think that's a bit of sarcasm. Well, down the whole street, windows are below ground level. New buildings are known to crack and settle shortly after being built. But is this what's really happening in these historical buildings? Other official explanation is that a cultural layer of dirt grows by about 1 meter every 100 years. But aren't streets regularly swept of dirt? Why should dirt accumulate? And then, apparently, staircases must then be built up to the second floor. And the second floor window becomes a door. And thus, the first floor becomes a cellar, or basement. And the second floor becomes the first. Logical facts about mud-buried buildings and cities is becoming more apparent every day. The historian can no longer be funny. With the internet, the truth is no longer hidden. Today, I will share with you a selection of 10 mud-flooded cities, which have mysterious dungeon floors that do not give rest to the researcher. In Moscow, there are many buried buildings. Again, you can write this all off as subsistence cultural layers, or mud-flood. I think that's a little sarcastic. Rhetorical. In 2017, during reconstruction of Moscow at the Polytechnic Museum, eyewitness researchers have discovered facts that baffle historians and the most ardent skeptics. In this video, the depth of the building shows that it was buried in some places more than 5 meters. Thousands of ground floor buried buildings can be found in Moscow. And, in this case, it is impossible to write off the buried foundation as a cultural subsistence layer given the depth, which is 5 meters. Builders know that the new buildings can settle in the ground shortly after construction. The settling eventually stops. And from working construction here in Ontario, this is me commenting, I've heard of this phenomenon before. I used to do drywall taping, and people would have cracks in their walls within the first couple years that their home was built. I don't like to add insight, but I think this is what he's talking about. Changing the subject, Thousands of kilometers of mysterious tunnels or dungeons exist underground. Nobody knows their exact extent. Today, we are told they are sewers built at the beginning of the 20th century. Some places are 68 meters long. Can you even imagine the amount of excavation work? Never mind the volume of bricks. And, not to mention, project documentation and road logistics. Historians assure us this was built by men with shovels and axes, and transported with horses. St. Petersburg is a paradise for the explorer. Everywhere you look presents riddles with the official history. Buried first and second floors are found. Even more strange, the official history says the city was built on swamp land. Only the most stubborn followers of history will say this is a sinking basement floor. How can they keep making excuses for flooded and marshy land and consequent embedded basements? To say buildings naturally sunk into the ground is illogical. Well, God blessed us with our historians. I think that's sarcasm. They force on us their explanation of buried basement windows. Here they go around every step of the palace square. Isn't it obvious that the main floor of the country's museum has at least one more underground floor? This picture shows flooding that happened. Did the flood bring with it sand and clay? This begs the question, why, after the flood, weren't the streets then cleared of sand and clay? Changing the subject slightly, in Tbilisi, in Georgia, in 2015, the whole city was flooded. When the city's people went to clear the mud, why then was not historic St. Petersburg cleared in similar fashion? Back to discussing St. Petersburg, there is also an extensive network of thousands of kilometers of tunnels that, according to official history, were built at the time of Peter Number One, by men with shovels and axes. This is strange, especially considering St. Petersburg was all built on swamp land. Thus, it would be especially necessary to do things like waterproofing. Something like this was tried in the 1990s in Kazan, but it was a failed attempt due to groundwater and increased expense of construction work. They ended up building an underground gallery, which was left unfinished, as will be discussed further, because now we're talking about Kazan. Below the city center is located underground, unfinished structures. Here they tried to erect underground streets. The project here was supposed to develop a shopping mall. This photo was taken just in time, during construction of an underground gallery. On it, it is clearly visible that the foundation is a buried building. Its depth is 5 meters from the current level of the street. Here are windows and doors 3 to 4 meters underground. Of course, the original architectural decision for the construction of the gallery went over budget and was too costly in the end. The project went unfinished. Please remember, the 1990s was a time with electricity, power tools, skilled workers, and modern construction equipment, not to mention truck transport. We are told that historically, semi-literate men with shovels in the 16th century knew how to build underground galleries through many kilometers of territory. Yes, 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 buried buildings in Kazan, there are thousands. There are also underground passages or tunnels in Kazan. According to the legends, Kazan has extensive tunnels below the whole city center. City information about tunnels is not available, but thanks to urban explorers, the truth is gradually becoming available. In Omsk, in 2016, the Ministry of Culture undertook reconstruction of the local museum, called Vrubel, and this opened the eyes of many. A floor with windows and doors was, for unknown reasons, buried below the surface. Yet, something happened historically where a layer of clay in a large enough depth of about 2 meters covered the first story of the building. Official historians will have a hard time explaining the underground floor. So the question, why does this underground floor have windows and a grand entrance? Historians cannot explain how the building for 100 years can develop such a deep cultural layer. They are now open to criticisms thanks to a mass number of photos that are now available on the internet. The depth is as deep as the length of a table. This is an opinion. Yearly millimeters of soil did not increase the cultural layer over this time. You can find numerous photos of this. Try searching for it yourself. Changing the subject, Egypt. Egypt, too, deserves a closer look. Here's what it looked like in the mid-19th century. Skeptics will point out it's a dusty place, and it may have occasionally had dust storms. However, on maps from the 17th century, this site surprisingly has many cities where deserts are today. Today, cities are not as numerous, and tend to be located only on the coast. Here's a look at some early photos. Moving on, here is a short clip which will explain why there are so many underground tunnels in Prague. Okay, this is me talking. I found it very technical to translate what is being discussed here, but having looked into this, Cromola is referencing a popular TV series which is called Cities of the Underworld. It basically shows a computer graphic rendition of why the street foundation had to be raised, and further, why tunnels are present underneath the streets in Prague in the Czech Republic. Cromola tends to remark on how the official story is absurd, and there's an explanation of this. And then he gives an opinion on how it's a little bit ridiculous. And particularly, he remarks on the effort that would have been required to transport and truck in clean landfill, which would have filled tunnels up to 68 meters long and as wide as the street. And he also mentions the vaulted archways and ceilings below the street level. I got a little bit lazy trying to translate this, but the next thing he discusses is Odessa, which is located in the south of Ukraine on the coast of the Black Sea. There is an extensive network of 2,500 kilometers of underground catacombs or tunnels. This is more than twice the amount, and it exceeds the tunnels found in Paris and Rome. In Odessa, a tour guide explains that the catacombs are a result of mining for stone. In these frames, you can see the excavation of Rome in the early 20th century. Apparently, this is when they finally got around to excavating. Cheerful workers throw soil into dump trucks. The excavated building is the famous Colosseum. Going back, it's hard to imagine that in Prague, about 700 years ago, they also would have done similar work as these dump trucks, which transport landfill or soil. Next, this has become an iconic image of mudflood, or the cultural layer phenomenon, dated around 1973 during construction in Paris. Remarks are made here about wrapped over metal fascia. I don't quite follow. And on the right, there's a fountain that is not visible. But the point is that you can see extensive underground structures. I'm not sure what's being said here, but this market was demolished in 1971, which I guess is in Paris, and all that remains is a big trench, and this remained for several years. Is this what we call ancient Rome? This video will be finished with a look to the Far East in Indonesia. The Indonesian island of Java had a tragedy by way of a mud volcano. volcano. They called one of the original eruptions Lucy. This has some connection to the Indonesian oil company. What happened to these buildings? They are covered. Maybe this can shed light on a better explanation for the accumulation of a cultural layer, and further that cultural layers are not the result of a few millimeters of dirt accumulation every year. This all requires more research, but the official historian's picture of the past is now crumbling. It's crumbling daily and before our eyes. Curious people are asking many questions. People whose eyes are not muddied by the dogma of historical science. This video has come to the end. If you enjoyed it, please be sure to visit Cremola's channel. Please consider leaving comments and consider giving his videos a thumbs up. Okay, once again, this is me talking. I just want to add that it was impossible for me to make a perfect translation with complete accuracy. In the least, I have provided the general message of this video. Please check out the original transcript if you have an issue. My intent was to make this information available to English-speaking people. But once again, very sincerely, thank you to Cremola for his video, and all credit goes to him. Have a good day.